Ayn Rand has lived one of the most remarkable lives of the 20th century. Born 76 years ago in Russia, educated at the University of Leningrad, she went on to become, in her best-selling novels and her non-fiction works, the world's foremost philosophical advocate of individualism, capitalism, and what she provocatively calls the virtue of selfishness. In a speech you made here for the National Committee for Monetary Reform, you suggested that American businessmen have become their own worst enemies. What do you mean by that?
Well, I didn't suggest. I stated it openly and firmly. I mean by that that the businessmen have dropped and ignored ideas completely. American businessmen believe for some reason that ideas are unimportant, irrelevant, and that they are practical when they deal in any matters other than the intellect. As a result of it, they are supporting universities and every other kind of organization preaching anti-businessmen and anti-capitalist propaganda.
Do you think businessmen are too apologetic about the profit motive?
Much. Much too apologetic, and that's the wrong sentence. I don't think you should be apologetic at all. Not that they're too apologetic. They are apologetic in a dreadful way, and they should not be. They should be proud of the profit motive.
I suppose some businessman might listening to you might think, well, it's all right for her to say, but I've got to sell my product, I've got to woo my customers. What would you say to such a person?
To begin with, he does not have to woo his customers, and it is much harder for me as an intellectual professional. I supposedly have to woo my readers, but do I? No, I state what I want to state, and those who agree with me will come to me. I don't want the others.
Is it your view that U.S. businesses should no longer support U.S. universities?
Yes, definitely. Or rather, they should stop supporting them. They should go on strike against the universities, demanding a fair practice, at least a fairness doctrine on the order of what television used to have, to present every important viewpoint.
You have spoken of the virtue of selfishness. Indeed, that was the title of one of your books. What would you say to all those Americans who believe they have an obligation to support their weaker fellow citizens through welfare and similar programs?
Fine, but let them do it. But they have no moral right to force me or any other American citizens to support the so-called downtrodden. They have no right to my work. They have no right to my life. I am free to do what I want to, and those Americans who believe in support should do it voluntarily and privately, fine. Not through government, not through taxes, not through force.
Some people think that the election of Ronald Reagan and similar political developments suggest a shift in the direction of the ideas you've been proposing. Yet you seem very gloomy about our future. Why?
Oh, because I don't think that Ronald Reagan represents proper kind of advocate of capitalism. He is not for capitalism. He stands for a mixed economy, and he's not a very good politician. I never voted for him. I didn't vote for anyone this time. But I do believe there is a shift to the right. The public is tired of the welfare state. They would like to return to some rational Americanism, but there is no intellectual leadership. None at all.
Thanks very much, Ayn Rand, a lady who thinks American businessmen should stop apologizing and get on with their business.